take over, off with it across the 35, across the 45, across the 50. Goes number nine, Aaron Hunt, and sets up the Hilltoppers at the Lancer 46-yard line. Wow.
That one's going to come back and bite you.
Could.
It, we understand what they're trying to do, get the ball down and low, and hope that they just pick up the ball and down it. But that time, the Hilltopper returner picked the ball up, picked up about 20, 25 yards on top of that.
Yep. Three wide receivers to the right, two here to the near side for EC Glass. Kendrick, the quarterback, will now bring Warren Horsley back with him. He takes the snap, keeping it on the option. Here's the pitch going wide to Horsley, and he's going to be brought down for a loss. Nice pursuit down there. Andre Brown. Horsley pushed a Lancer player, Samari Brogdon, and, I mean, no flag
right
at all. That was basically a punch. Loss of a yard on the play.
And Brogdon's going to have to come off the field because his helmet popped off. Good pursuit there. They telegraphed that pitch just a little bit, but good pursuit by the Lancers.
Here's Kendrick keeping it going to the right side, a big hole. 40, 35, gets to the 30 down the far sideline. Is knocked out of bounds inside the 25. Actually, they'll spot it right at the 25-yard line. Dangerous, dangerous runner and thrower. Trayshawn Kendrick.
And that's how he becomes the leading rusher for the Hilltoppers. He's pulling that ball down and scrambling for 22 yards like that.
First and 10 for EC Glass at the Lancer 25-yard line. Ball spotted on the far hash. Twin wide receivers to either side. Now a man in motion. Here's the handoff going to that right side to Brown. He's hit by Wade Wheeler. Tackled was Wade Wheeler and no call. Brown comes back the other way. 20, 15 to the 10. Cuts in at the 10-yard line. Cuts in at the 5 and scores.
Touchdown.
Make that Justin Burnett. My fault. Wow.
Yeah, you can't let that happen. Justin Barnett looked like he was going to be dropped for about a 3-yard loss by Wade Wheeler in the backfield. A Hilltopper grabbed Wade, pulled
and tackled
off.
And nothing called. Yeah.
Barnett reversed his field, came all the way back across, and just weaved his way 25 yards into the end zone.
A couple of missed tackles in there, too. Barnett will be the holder here for McCarthy's extra point try. And the kick is up, and it is good. 2:28 left to go in the first half. New score. It is now EC Glass 28 and Amherst County 13. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG on WAMVRadio.com and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network. Glass has had it added on to their lead on a 25-yard run by Justin Barnett. McCarthy's kick has made it 28-13 in favor of the Hilltoppers. Like I said, 2:28 left to go in the second quarter.
And we stand where we were about 5 minutes ago where the Lancers have to respond. I mean, they've come out and punched us in the mouth again. We've got to be able to respond.
That all started with field position.
Yes, it did.
McCarthy getting set to kick it off from right to left. Puts the boot into it again, and Samari Brogdon's just going to let it bounce into the end zone. Touchback will give it to the Lancers on their own 20. No time runs off the clock as well. Hey, don't forget to check us out on Facebook on our Lancer Radio Facebook page. Just go to Facebook and search for Lancer Radio. It's two words. Say hello to us there, or you can check us out on Twitter at Lancer Radio 1. First and 10 for the Lancers. Ball spotted in the middle of the field. They'll scrimmage from their own 20-yard line. Trailing 28-13. Frank Ross, the signal caller. Two receivers to the left. Takes the snap. Fakes it to Xavier Ellis. Keeps it going outside. Can he get a block? No, he's going to be dragged down from behind. As a matter of fact, once again, it was Tyler. I don't have a 58 on my roster. Oh, there he is. Holden Fretz wears 58 on the away jerseys. 19 at home. Gets about a yard out of it, does Frank Ross. It'll be second down and nine.
And if he had been able to break through that hold, Xavier Ellis was there to make the block to spring him.
Yep.
But not able to get free of that first man in the backfield.
Second down and nine. Play clock down to 10 as the Lancers get to the line of scrimmage. Ross, looking over the defense, takes the snap, wants to throw, and he's going to be sacked. Back at the 12-yard line. Once again, it is Fretz back there to get him.
And Fretz was back there almost as fast as the ball was. That he came in free without being hit at all. Well, I think they were a little gracious with that spot, too.
Yes, I agree. It was spotted at the 16-yard line, so only a loss of five on the play. It'll be third down and 14 now for the Lancers with approaching 1 minute to go in this second quarter.
Looked like they were going to try a little swing pass out to the far side of the field that time.
D'Angelo Brown is out there now as the wide receiver to the left. Here's the handoff to Xavier Ellis looking for running room. Gets across the 20, leaps over a pass player at the 30. Did he get the first down? Yes, he did at the 32-yard line.
Wow.
And he got out of bounds with 48 seconds left to go in the second quarter.
Let's see what we can do here. That was exciting.
It'll be first and 10 for the Lancers at their own 33-yard line. That was the hurdle. That's what that was. Does he run hurdles, I wonder, in track?
Was watching,
yes,
I'm sure. Blaine Johnson in.
D'Angelo Brown is the wide receiver here to the right with Samari Brogdon. Johnson will hand it off to Frank Ross. And once again, it is Fretz who comes in to wreak havoc. And then to finish off Frank Ross, it is Jaden Merriman. And a loss of three on the play. Lancers have all three of their timeouts here. 36 seconds to go in the half.
And I'm not sure why we're not expending some at this point as the clock continues to run.
Yep, there'll be about a five-second differential between the game clock and the play clock. So this might be the final play of the half right here.
It should be.
Second down and 13 after the loss on the previous play. Ross takes the snap, keeping it himself going left this time. He's going to be hit and dropped at the 30. No gain on the play. Making up the grab on that play was Warren Horsley. That's the way we're going to end the first half of play. With our score, the EC Glass Hilltoppers 28 and the Amherst County Lancers 13. We'll be back with the Lancers Halftime Show after we step aside for this timeout. You're listening to Lancers Football, 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG, WAMVRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network. Welcome back to Lancer Stadium, where we have gone to halftime. And the Lancers are trailing the EC Glass Hilltoppers by a score of 28-13. Eric, Carrie, Ricky, and Chloe on hand. And we'll hear from Chloe here in just a few minutes with the halftime scoreboard. Get you up to date on to see the first quarter where EC Glass pretty much dominated the first two possessions. Defense seemed to come alive for the Lancers a little bit. But offensively, Amherst still having trouble moving the football right now.
When your best offense, well, probably not your best offensive play, but one of your better offensive plays is a punt that hits off of the Hilltoppers. That does seem to indicate some struggle. Immediately after that, though, Frank Ross with a 40. But other than that, thank you.
High School Marching Lancers. At this time, I'd like to introduce you to the seniors. Starting off is Abigail Hartless, daughter of Lewis and Kelly Hartless and sister of Samuel Hartless. She wants to attend the University of Pennsylvania to major in linguistics and major in computer science. Karina Davis, daughter of Helen and Randy Davis, hoping to attend Brigham Young University after going on a mission for her church. She will major in mechanical engineering. Devon Wright, son of Wendy Jones and David Wright, attending CBCC and then UVA, not sure about her major. Grace Prim, daughter of Rudy and Donna Prim, will attend Sweetbriar College in the fall of 2019. She will double major in biology and chemistry and minor in environmental science. Her goal is to become a biomedical researcher focused on diseases affecting human genomes. Isabella Billings, daughter of Christine and James Billings. James is out on a business trip, but is still here with us via Skype. Also joining her parents is her twin brother, Sebastian Billings, and her younger sister, Lilith Billings. Isabella plans on attending Radford University and study graphic design and animation, as well as study in psychology. Now for the senior, I always mess up his last name, Jeffrey Preslebeck. Son of Scotty and Thomas Preslebeck and brother of Melissa Henson and Jenny Rittler. He wants to attend Virginia Tech to major in physics to pursue his career in astronomy. Jeff tells the marching band to always drink water. Jillian Wade, daughter of Angelique Calvert and Kevin Wade. She is joined with stepdad Tim Calvert, sister Miranda Calvert, and grandparents Debbie and John Bowling, attending CBCC in the fall and then to JMU. Next is Landon Childress, son of David and Sharon Childress and brother of Bryson and Connor Childress. He will be attending CBCC for another year. He hopes to keep up with his wrestling career in college when he transfers to a four-year school. Next is Mason Pickren, son of Miranda Combs and Jason Pickren, hopefully joining U.S. Navy to work on electronics. Next is Tamara Wooten, daughter of Danica and Scott Taylor, and sister to Madison Boone and Will Edwards. She will be attending CBCC and then transferring to Johnson and Wales for culinary arts. Next is Willow Litchford, daughter of Susan and William Litchford and sister of James Litchford. She plans on attending Radford University in the fall to study forensic chemistry and criminal justice. And our final senior, Zamari Morgan, son of Fernando Penix, grandson of Sherman and Dale Penix, nephew of Latasha Penix, Cordell Penix. He will be attending the University of Lynchburg in the fall to study whenever his heart desires. Ladies and gentlemen, give a big hand to your seniors in the 2018 Amherst County High School Marching Lancers.
I don't think it's the cost of a stamp why we don't write letters. I think it's the cost of our time. Yeah, we didn't realize that we weren't going to communicate by letter as much as we did then. So in that sense, I suppose these letters to themselves are becoming more valuable because they're different. Well, initially, I started the exercise because I wanted the students to do an assignment that was different, that would be interesting, and one that they would value.
I always get people cards and write little notes and that sort of thing, but when it comes to actually sitting down and writing a 10-page letter, that's a pretty huge commitment.
I thought it was just a lesson just to pass the time, to keep us busy for a few hours while he did other things. But honestly, the lesson is quite brilliant, actually, and I guess it's looking back and remembering who you were.
It was a 10-page letter they had to write to themselves, and it would be returned by me to them in, I suggested, 20 years.
I think it just shows how dedicated of a teacher he was, you know, and that he really, you know, he really was thinking about people and you know, kids themselves when he was doing these letters, because to keep them that long and, you know, and to get them all out, you know.
He does this year after year, diligently. To think that somebody has that much commitment to keep the momentum of this going for decades, that's a pretty unique person right there.
Today, when everybody is so busy, so often people are just worried about, you know, what's in it for me? What does he get out of storing all these letters and trying to track people down? And like, not everybody stays close by.
That's a lot of work. I don't know. I haven't asked him how many hours it would take him, but I gotta assume we're a couple weeks every year just to get those all organized.
For me, there's a lot of detective work. Kids are going every which way, and this excites me. Many generations ago, when letters were carefully written, this was the only way that we could have that person in our home. The letter almost represents part of that person who is sending it. Because as we opened that letter, there was that person there.
I think I was just so excited to read the letter and a little bit leery about how vapid I would have been at that age, that I wasn't really fully prepared for reading about my grandmother or my aunt who passed away. I wasn't quite expecting that emotional roller coaster. So, yeah.
It's a shock. Like, oh yeah, I did think that way.
I think the world will become more of a computerized world with computerized cars and ships and computerized robots.
And then all of a sudden, we are reminded of some of the hopes that we did have when we were younger.
Someday I would like to go and visit the world. The place I'd love to go the most is England and see the Thames River, the giant clock called Big Ben in Buckingham Palace. Little did Darren know that a couple of years after this letter, he did get to go to England.
As a parent, if I think back to what was in my letter, that will help me appreciate where she is.
In 20 years, I hope to be living in California on the beach with a good tan and one hunk of a good man.
It's so weird.
It's the grade 9 brain, okay?
It's all just kind of looking back at these memories and just kind of having this opportunity to digest them. It's like this little gift of somebody that I've forgotten years ago.
There's not too many people that would ever think to do something like this. And it, you know, that's something that we're all gonna have for the rest of our lives. It's like opening your first Christmas present again.
Like, it's not a letter, it's a keepsake, because you can't get rid of something like that.
He was one of those teachers that you never thought of him as the cool teacher or the one that you talked about very much. And now you look at him in a different perspective because he's done something like this for you.
How many teachers can say they've done that for so many students, contributed to their life or to, you know, giving back something?
I really hope that that happens. I hope that other teachers take this idea and roll with it, because it's phenomenal. I can't tell you how special it is to me to be able to go back and read something that I wrote to myself when I was that age.
And if he could only see, you know, what these things meant to us years down the road, you know, the profound experience that is reading a letter from yourself as a child, I think that he should, you know, pat himself on the back.
The amount of interest that has been generated over this assignment is just, I had no idea that anything would ever end up like this.
I know I'm not an outstanding teacher. I'm just a regular teacher who happened to assign a rather different assignment.
I'm not mistaken, so that's probably a rematch as well for those two teams.
Brookville certainly would want that rematch, since
yes,
they ended up losing to Liberty
in the final minutes, as a matter of fact,
exactly,
or being
right,
held in the final minutes to not being able to score.
I know Rustburg is still on the outside looking in, but they're hoping things fall their way tonight
to be able to slide from 10. It would take so much. Fort Defiance getting struck by lightning, Broadway's bus going off the side of the curb, but everybody's okay.
That's right.
That
Please.
Kind of thing. It would be that kind of a thing in order for that to happen. They have 18.78 points right now. And to give you and they've got to get a full point just from Broadway losing. And that's Broadway's 19.56. Fort Defiance is 20.11. It's not looking real good for Rustburg's chances, even if they do defeat Liberty here tonight.
I was going to say, it starts with them defeating Liberty, and that's not happening at this point. So,
although still a very low-scoring game.
Yes, it is.
Last report. Getting ready to start the second half here at Lancers Stadium, with the Lancers trailing EC Glass 28-13. Glass is going to be getting the football. They won the toss to start the game and deferred to the second half. So that dangerous Glass offense will be on the field to start this third quarter. Oakland and San Francisco underway in the NFL.
In the Who Cares Bowl?
Oh, yeah, the 1-8 versus 1-7. 1-8 versus 1-7. And again, it's the NFL, so I don't care anyway.
There you go.
That just kind of seals the deal for me. Lane Johnson's got it teed up roughly the middle of the field at the 40-yard line.
Let's see what they do to change over the way their kicks have been going.
Yep. Warren Horsley is back deep for the Hilltoppers to our right. Here's the run-up and the kickoff. It's a little pooch kick this time. Going to be taken at the 26-yard line, and somebody must have called for a fair catch. Because Aaron Hunt was getting ready to take off with the ball after the whistle had been blown dead. But so the Hilltoppers will end up on their own 28-yard line. Not bad, really,
no, that
if
was
you think
effective.
About it.
Very effective.
So the Hilltoppers moving from right to left in their white unis with the blue helmets. The Lancers all in gray. On the defensive side, three wide receivers to the far side right. One here to the near side. Here's Kendrick. On the low snap, he's going to take off with it. He's got a lot of room over here if he can take advantage, but he gets tripped up at about the 36-yard line. It's going to be a gain of about 8 yards on the play. Let's see where they end up spotting this thing. They're giving him a pretty darn good spot up at the 37-yard line, so it's like actually a gain of 9. Second down and a yard here for the Hilltoppers.
Wow.
Didn't look quite right. Pistol formation for Kendrick. Here's the inside handoff, Foster. Comes across the 40, gets ahead to the 45-yard line. He'll have a first down. Does Ty Foster for the Hilltoppers up and around, actually, their own 46. Ty Foster, the second leading rusher on the Hilltoppers, did not play in the first quarter. You have to wonder about that.
Right.
Mostly it was Horsley playing running back along with number 20, Quatarius Craighead, in that first half of play. Kendrick from the pistol. Play action, rolling to his right. He's in trouble. He is sacked. Wade Wheeler got him all the way back at the 34-yard line. Wow. They'll spot it at the 35, but what a great play by Wade Wheeler.
11 yards, loss on play. And that time, Jershawn Kendrick was trying to use the same action from the play before and then was going to bootleg, but when he turned around, number 44 was staring him right in the face and took him down.
Offset in the backfield in the pistol. Kendrick will take the snap, play action pass. Now he'll take off with it, going to the left across the 40. Gets up ahead to about the 45-yard line. Knock out of bounds there. Gain of about 10 on the play. Chambers making the stop. It'll be third down and 11 for the Hilltoppers. This is a big third down early here.
Just getting ready to say, defense steps up here. This could be positive for the Lancers.
Here's the third down play, third down and 11 for the Hilltoppers at their own 45-yard line. Kendrick wants to throw all the way, goes towards the near sideline, intended for Wyatt Hamilton, but it's incomplete. And for the first time tonight, the Hilltoppers will be punting. On to handle that duty is Tyler Garrett. Samari Brogdon will drop back to receive the punt. Chaz Jackson coming up a little limpy on that last play, or after that last play.
Looks like it's just cramps.
If that is the case. Brogdon standing on about his own 22 to our left. Garrett will punt this from his own 31. Good snap. Puts the boot into it. High kick. Brogdon should have run up on that one. And it takes a big-time EC Glass bounce down inside the 15-yard line and down to the 12. Brogdon, a mid. Brogdon, a junior, he'll be back next year, and he'll have more experience under his belt.
That's exactly right.
And that's the big thing right now for Samari Brogdon. But the Lancers have to start deep in their own territory, trailing 28-13 with 10:17 to go in this third quarter. Their first drive of this thrown 13-yard line on the near hash. Two wide receivers here to the near side. Wheeler, the H-back, set to that side as well. Ross will keep it. Going to the left. Doesn't get much, maybe a yard. Still a lot of penetration in there. Even by the defensive end that time, it was Drayon Browley coming in from his defensive end spot to make the tackle. So it'll be second down and 9.
It's interesting. Against the Bulldogs of Lynchburg, Liberty Christian, all of our yardage seemed to come up the middle between the two tackles. Just not getting a whole lot since then at all.
Two wide receivers to the left. Man in motion is D'Angelo Brown. Here's the handoff to Brown going to the right side, trying to find some running room. He'll get ahead out of bounds at about the 20, or make that the 19-yard line. Let's see if they actually spot it at the 20. They do. It'll be third down and 3 here. Gain of 6 on the play.
It was an upfield spot, yes.
I like it. That doesn't happen often. Told Chloe earlier, I'll repeat it. I'm not on the Christmas card list, that's for sure.
Need this first down, guys.
Yep. Ball on the near hash on the third down and 3 play. Two receivers here to the near side. That's Brown and Brogdon. Wade Wheeler will go and set up to the left. Ross will take it, keep it himself, going to that left side, looking for running room. Did he get the first down? I think he did. Yes, he did. Up and around the 25-yard line. Gain of 5 on the play.
That's enough for another Amherst Lancers.
Big play there. Big pickup there. And right here, we're seeing that 4 or 5 yards in a cloud of dust that I talked about during the pregame show tonight that was going to be so important for Amherst to keep that Glass offense off the field.
Without a doubt.
So the ball on the far hash on a 1st and 10 for the Lancers at their own 25-yard line. Brown here to the wide to the right. Brogdon is in the slot. Here's Ross keeping it going to the left. Finds a little seam ahead to about the 29. Did they give him the 30? Nope. It'll be the 29-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play.
And on first down, that's effective enough.
And especially with this offense.
That's right.
You want the 3s, the 4s, anywhere from 3 to 6, and a single wing on first down,
right.
I'll take it.
Absolutely.
Second down and 6 here for the Lancers. D'Angelo Brown has come in, is now playing the wide out here to the right side for Chaz Jackson. Hand off. Nope, they're going to do the reverse. Nope. Xavier Ellis still has it across the 35. Trucks a man at the 40 and gets ahead to the 46-yard line. He ran right over Warren Horsley to get the first down and more for Amherst County.
Makes you wonder whether he had the option on that play to keep it or hand it, because looks like he took a look, certainly faked the hand of the reverse back the other way. But great pickup there. And we've got some momentum going on the offensive side here right now.
1st and 10 for Lancers at their own 46-yard line. Ball on the near hash as Frank Ross, the signal caller, barks out signals, takes the snap. Play action. Fake to Ellis, keeps it going up the middle and picks up about 2.
Got a Lancer down.
Yep.
Looks like Holden Ayers.
Again, yep. He's already been injured once this season, was out for a couple of ball games, and now he's riding on the field at this point. Injury timeout on the field with 7:39 going in the third quarter. 28-13 Glass leads Amherst. You're listening to Lancers football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG. WAMVRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancer Sports Network. Drive started on their own 13. Frank Ross, the signal caller, puts a man in motion. That's D'Angelo Brown. They'll hand it to Brown. He gets hit in the backfield, breaks the tackle, but will not break anymore. Why aren't they blowing the whistle? No gain on the play. That was ugly from the start. Only way to put that.
And that's what penetrates. Does for you. Blew the play up before it ever had a chance to get started.
So third down and eight. I don't know that there's been a more important third down in this ball game than this one right here. Simply to keep this drive alive, if nothing else.
The offense has built up some momentum. It doesn't need to stop here. This becomes a key third down with 8 yards to go.
D'Angelo Brown in motion. Frank Ross in trouble in the backfield, and he'll be brought down back at the 42. Loss of six on the play. Again, that just looked ugly. And penetration was the key again.
Yes.
So it's going to be fourth down and 15, and the Lancers are going to have to punt. They ate up some clock. That was about it on that drive.
They will shift the field position just a little bit from where they were, but didn't get the points we were looking for.
Blaine Johnson to punt it away here. High kick. Going to drop inside the 25. Take a Lancers bounce inside the 20 and down to about the 17-yard line. So good punt by Blaine. Takes us to the 5:49 mark of the third quarter. And the Lancers trailing 28-13. Our coverage of Lancers football brought to you in part by Bill's Body Shop, 1340 North Amherst Highway near 151. If you got to find the right body shop, find Bill's, because Bill's combines the latest technology and the most skillful people. I'm not lying when I tell you, you need to call Bill's Body Shop, 946-1115. And would I lie? I don't think so. So here are the Hilltoppers starting this drive from their own 17-yard line. Quiet, you.
I didn't even say anything.
I knew what was coming. Here's Kendrick taking the snap and a whistle or a flag's down or it was a timeout call. Not sure. What is this all about? Procedure against the Hilltoppers. False start. Winning 50-50 ticket. So move it back five. We'll take that.
Back them up.
Five. Two. So it'll be first and 15 now for the Hilltoppers from their own 12-yard line. Ball spotted on the far hash. Pistol formation in the backfield. Two wide receivers here to the near side. Two to the far side right. Kendrick calls for the football, takes the snap, hands it off to Foster. Going to the right. He'll get that 5 yards back. The original line of scrimmage, the 17. And it'll be second down and 10 for the Hilltoppers. Glass wastes no time getting to the line of scrimmage. By the way, Chaz Jackson's back out there playing one of the cornerback positions right now. Here's Kendrick keeping it with a big hole across the 20. Breaks a tackle there. Gets outside to the 25. Gets tripped up behind. Samari Brogdon at the 26-yard line, short of the first down.
Nice play by Brogdon, slicing through. He came from the far side of the field to make that play.
Wow, they gave him a great spot up and around the 27-yard line. Very, very close to the first down. That's going to be third down in about a half yard here. So three wide receivers to the far side, one here to the near. Kendrick in a pistol formation, takes the snap. We'll hand it off to Foster. Foster hit at the line of scrimmage, but he'll break the tackle and may have gotten enough for the first down, but we'll see. Spots the thing.
Far side.
Yep, they got it. Yep. Got it by about a yard. Lancers did get good penetration that time.
They did.
Devontae Sandage has got a stinger or something on his left arm. He's going to have to come out. And Kevin Carter will come into the ball game to play one of those up front positions. It'll be first and 10 on their own 28-yard line. Pistol formation in the backfield. Wide receiver here to the near side, three to the right. Foster in the backfield with Kendrick. Three wide receivers to the right, one here to the near side. Kendrick takes the snap, wants to throw. Gets the short out, and a broken tackle there by Wyatt Hamilton as he gets ahead to about the 41-yard line. And a first down for the Hilltoppers. I did not see who missed the tackle there. But it'll be first and 10 for the Hilltoppers at their own 41-yard line.
Well, they juked him out of his shoes there and able to pick up the extra yardage needed for the first down.
Kendrick takes it, hands off. Foster going right. Foster will be brought down after a gain of about five. Ahead to about the 46-yard line. And now you get the feeling that Glass is just trying to be methodical here. Short passes, a lot of running plays.
And Ty Foster really looks like a downhill runner. He gets up to speed quickly and just hits straight into the middle of the line. Gets what he can, gets down, and resets the clock.
Second down and 4 after... The run by Foster. Going to hand it to him again. Going to the right. Picks his way through. Gets into Lancer territory. Close to a first down. I think he's got it from that spot. As the ball's nose is inside the 49-yard line, so it should be a first down. Yep. 2:56 to go in this third quarter. Lancers are trailing 28-13. And need a defensive stop here.
To me, if you're the Hilltoppers, you keep running that play till they stop it. I mean, they're grabbing 5 yards of play right now.
Two wide receivers here to the near side. Man in motion. That's Barnett. Kendrick wants to throw. It's that short out again. And he breaks a tackle again. Does Wyatt Hamilton as he gets down to the Lancer 43-yard line. Make it to 42. It's going to be second down and 3 here.
Gain of 7 yards, second down and 3.
And again, pick up those 3 to 6 yards on first down and the whole playbook opens up to you.
Second down and 3 here for the Hilltoppers. And in motion is Barnett. They'll give it to him on that end around. He's got some blockers out ahead of him as he gets inside the 40, down to the 36-yard line and a first down for EC Glass.
Tackled by number 5, Andre Brown.
And they're really in, if you think about it, just daring the Lancers to stop them at this point.
Well, that's 4 straight first downs on this particular drive. As they started back on their own 17, went back to the 12, and now find themselves in Lancer territory threatening.
First and 10 at the Lancer 36-yard line. Ball on the far hash as Kendrick takes it, hands it off. Foster going to the right. Finds a seam, gets inside the 25, and down close to the 23-yard line for a first down.
Gain of 13 yards. First and 10, Hilltoppers.
And that's 5 consecutive first downs.
They've only had 1 third down on this drive, if I'm not mistaken. Is that right?
The very first series.
Yep. First down and 10. Here's the play action. Kendrick going to take off with it to the right, getting out of the pocket inside the 10. He'll go out of bounds at the 8-yard line. It's going to be first and goal for EC Glass. In that case, Kendrick just made the play.
Well, he looked up. He was looking downfield, looking for a receiver that was open. Didn't find him. saw lots of room, just took off running. And that's what makes him so dangerous.
First and goal for the Hilltoppers at the 8-yard line. Kendrick, handoff, Foster going right, bounces it outside, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, EC Glass. Actually, that was four, wasn't it? Horsley. With his second touchdown of the night with 1:16 to play here in the third.
Hilltoppers making it look easy on that particular drive.
Very methodical. They ate up a bunch of clock.
12 play drive, moving the length of the field.
Here's McCarthy on to try the PAT. Well, that's kind of redundant. PAT stands for try. So. Kick is in the air, whichever way you want to look at it, and it is good. EC Glass increases their lead here at Lancer Stadium. They now lead the Lancers 35-13. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG, WAMDRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network. Horsley has increased the EC Glass lead here after McCarthy's kick. It is 35-13 in favor of the Hilltoppers with 1:16 left to go in this third quarter. You're talking about a Lancers offense that is not built to come from behind this far. Here's the run up by McCarthy. And he'll put the line drive boot into it, and it will actually, does it go out of bounds? Went into the end zone.
Went okay. Into the end zone.
Awful close.
It was very close. That pylon was looking at it awful tight.
So the Lancers will get it on their own 21st and 10. Trailing 35-13, 1:16 to play in this third quarter.
We need a home run here.
Here comes the sports cliche. It's sports cliche night at the ballpark. First and 10 for the Lancers. Here is the handoff to Frank Ross, going to the right side, and he is going to be brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Nope, he'll push ahead. About the 21, there is a flag down at the 19-yard line. Check everything here as Blaine Johnson was out there. Check and see what this is all about. Now the single wing look will make its way back out onto the field. Personal foul face mask again by EC Glass. Second time they've been called for that tonight. That'll give the Lancers a first down at about the 36-yard line. Comes at the end of the play. They'll actually spun it at the 37. First and 10 for Amherst County. 1:07 to go in this third quarter.
All right. There's the momentum we need. See if the offense can.
Carrie Forless, Ricky Rutland, Cole Ramsey back here at Lancers Stadium. Ready to start the fourth quarter of play. Amherst County struggling with the East Glass Hilltoppers by a score of 35-13.
Hilltoppers are. And Blaine's punting has been. He had one game where he shanked a few, but.
There was a lot of pressure.
More often than not, he turns the ball over nicely and has been an asset for us this second this year.
So first and 10 for the Hilltoppers. They'll make that 12-yard line. Kendrick, the quarterback at a pistol.
First pick in the draft.
Is that what they're doing?
I feel like you have some more words about this.
No, I can't stand the NFL. That's basically what it comes down. I'm sorry, folks. I know there are fans out there listening who are still going to watch on Sunday and Monday and Thursday and every other day of the week. But sorry, just don't like it. All right, what do you got for us there, Chloe?
I have Gretna and Dan River, 35-0. Gretna is leading in the fourth quarter. It still says Rappahannock and Nelson are in the half, okay, with so Nelson leading 35-14.
Minor detail.
Yep.
William Campbell is leading 42-14 against Chatham in the fourth quarter. And Rustburg and Liberty are also in the fourth quarter, tied at 7-7.
Wow.
That's been a tough game.
Yeah. I mean, Rustburg is trying to do everything they can to make sure that they at least have a shot at the playoffs. Derek Chambers is the injured Lancer, one of the best defenders on this squad, and a senior.
Hate to see it end that way for a senior out there on the field. College game tonight, Temple leading number 12 Central Florida by a score of 27-21 late in the second quarter.
How about that? Wasn't UCF undefeated at one point?
They still are.
Okay. So that would be a big upset. That's like a Conference USA maybe game, something like that.
Sounds right.
Second down and 10 for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick will take it, keeping himself going to the left side. Big hole. Across the 20, across the 25, and ahead to the 26-yard line. They'll have the first down and more on the 14-yard run. Game 10:46 to play in this one here at Lancer Stadium. Amherst trailing 35-13. First and 10 for the Hilltoppers at their own 26-yard line. Kendrick takes the snap, hands it off, going to the left side as Horsley breaks it outside across 35 and a hit to near the 40-yard line. Pick up a 14 more there for first down.
The Hilltoppers were more than ready for that play. They were down and ready and set about, eight seconds before Amherst was.
They run this offense quick, no doubt about that.
And their team speed,
yeah,
is evident out there right now. They hit the hole quickly, where our plays just take too long sometimes to develop.
First and 10. Here's Kendrick going to keep it. Finds a seam on the left side, 45. Ahead to about the 49-yard line.
Did anyone else see that guy drop the sign?
Yeah, well, he's going to run for it. I would too. And it's broke now. Did you see that? When he picked it up, the thing fell off the front. The little flag on the front of it fell off. So now he's going to have to hold that thing the whole night. Or what's left of it.
Is that where you yell, yikes?
Yeah.
And away?
Yeah, yikes and away. And then if you're hit, it's yikes and away. Two receivers here to the near side. Second down and two for the Hilltoppers. Yes, we're a little punch drunk. Hand off right inside. Oh, big hole for the fullback into Lancer territory to the 41-yard line. Check that number for you. See who that was. That was Xavius Hager. It's going to be first and 10 for the Hilltoppers at the Lancer 40. Two wide receivers here to the near side, one to the far as the Hilltoppers move from left to right here in the fourth quarter. Kendrick takes it, hands it off to number 20. That was Quatarius Craighead. He'll gain a couple. Upended by Kevin Carter.
Upended was putting it nicely there.
Well, he was trying to jump over his own offensive lineman, and Carter kind of grabbed him and slung him as he did so. It was impressive.
Makes it look a whole lot worse than it was.
Second down and eight here. Handoff is to Craighead once again. Breaks a tackle in the backfield. Gets inside the 35 to about the 32-yard line. Let's see where they end up spotting this thing. It'll be third down and about a yard for the Hilltoppers. More important for Glass is they just keep this spot just a rolling right now. Third down and one. Kendrick will hand off to Craighead again. He'll have the first down inside the 30 and down close to the 25-yard line. And it'll be a first down for EC Glass. Once again, just a methodical come right at you, stop us if you can drive by the Hilltoppers.
Yeah, they're throwing down the gauntlet right now and say, we're going to do what we do, try to stop us. But, the Lancers have had no answer.
Ball spotted at the Lancer 26-yard line on the far hash. First and 10, EC Glass. Man in motion. Here's the end around to Barnett. Barnett inside or down to about the 21-yard line. It's tackled there by Lawrence Brown, freshman who's into the ball game. Had some help from Andre Brown.
Well, guys, it looks like Derek Chambers is up and ready to go, walking all over here on the sideline, and Holden Ayers has officially been given crutches.
Here's the handoff inside to Craighead as he's inside the 20, down close to the 18-yard line. Going to be a gain of about two on the play. Another third down coming up here for the Hilltoppers, but they pretty much converted every third down here in the second half. Going to be third down and three here.
They actually haven't faced all that many third downs in this half. But those they have faced, they have converted.
The Lancers can stop them here, and they might be able to hold them to a field goal try. They got to stop them first. Kendrick, with Craighead to his right, takes the snap. We'll hand it off to Craighead, going to the left side, and is awful close. Boy, not sure. Once again, the spot's the thing. Let's see.
White Hat was holding up a fourth down.
Yeah, it is. Fourth down and about a yard. Hilltoppers are going for it. Interesting. Pistol formation in the backfield. Don't be surprised if Kendrick just keeps it here. They've got an H-back set here to the right side.
Craighead up the middle.
Yep. They do give it to Craighead, who will have the first down.
Number 20, Craighead.
Inside the 15, down to the 12-yard line. Tackled by Austin Purvis.
First and 10, Hilltoppers.
It'll be first and 10 at the Lancer 12 for the Hilltoppers. 6:20 left to go in the game. When did this drive begin, Kerry?
Started at the 11-minute mark. They've eaten up 5 minutes of clock.
Wow. Two wide receivers to the left, one here to the near side. Craighead is the setback in the pistol. He'll get the call. Bounces it outside, cuts it back in, and he will score. Touchdown. For the Hilltoppers from 13 yards out for Craighead, his second touchdown of the night with 5:54 to go in the game.
That was a 13-play drive, ate up 5 minutes of clock, and they have succeeded in putting this game out of reach.
Yeah, with 5:54 left to go and an offense that is not built for come from behind. McCarthy looking to hit his seventh extra point try. tonight. The kick is in the air, and it is good. 5:54 left to play in this ball game. New score, EC Glass 42 and Amherst County 13. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Supertalk 1050 WBRG, WAMVRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports. It's just you and I, stop to it, burn it bright. When we collide. 13-yard run by Kateryus Craig, had his second touchdown of the night. Increased the EC Glass lead here at Lancers Stadium, 42-13. After Benjamin McCarthy's kick for extra point. 5:54 left to play in this ball game. Hilltoppers will go into their game next Friday night as the number 2 seed in Region 4D. There's a lot of good teams in that region.
There's
a lot of good teams.
It'll be exciting to watch the playoffs play out.
Here's the run up and the kick by McCarthy, returnable by Samari Brogdon, coming here to the near side. Across the 15, across the 20, 25, stays on his feet, up and around the 30-yard line. Very close to another face mask call against the Hilltoppers as the kickoff return or kickoff coverage player was reaching. For Samari Brogdon. Oh boy, they give him a good one up and around the 33-yard line. We'll take that.
Absolutely.
Our coverage of Lancers football being brought to you in part by The Store on South Amherst Highway in Madison Heights. They're serving up the good fried chicken. Hot dogs, too. The Store can handle all your big social and church events. And they're steaming shrimp now.
Shrimp
at The Store in Madison Heights. Don't think they're putting it like in kebabs and all that stuff.
Lemon shrimp, pan-fried shrimp.
See, why did I even say anything? First and 10 for the Lancers. Here's a handoff. Wade Wheeler going around that right side looking for blockers, and he's actually going to lose a yard on the play. They had a couple of running plays in for Wade Wheeler when he was playing that H-back position last year, in addition to this great pass play that I'd love to see them run. No gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10. That was interesting.
Not used to seeing number 44 with the ball under his arm like that.
Kevin Carter had actually come on instead of Xavier Ellis as an extra blocker and to play H-back on that play. Two wide receivers to the right side. That's Brogdon and Chaz Jackson on second down and 10 for the Lancers. Frank Ross takes it, hands it off. Here's the reverse to D'Angelo Brown across the 40. It gets ahead to about the 42-yard line. He might be about a yard shy of the first down.
Looks like where they're marking it.
Yep.
It's going to be a nice play.
Third down in about a yard. After the 9-yard gain by Brown.
Blaine Johnson set to come on the field for this third and one.
Yeah. Third down, 1-1. Maybe you try something a little different here, too. If you ask me, is my papers and pens and everything else blow all over the place? I have no idea where the pen went.
Uh-oh.
Okay, Chloe's got it. Here's the snap to Johnson. Handoff is to Frank Ross, and he'll have the first down up and around the 45-yard line. That's enough for another first down for Amherst County with their own 45-yard line with 3:57 to go in the game. You know, if you could eat up the rest of this clock and score some points to finish this thing off, that would be outstanding.
Absolutely. That was only the third first down for Amherst in the second half, where wow. EC Glass has 11 first downs in the second half of action.
Jackson and Brown will be wide here to the near side. Wade Wheeler kind of lined up as a slot back as well. Handoff is to Xavier Ellis. He is in all kinds of trouble, and he's going to be brought down back at the 35-yard line. Loss of 10 on the play. And again, big penetration by the interior of the EC Glass Hilltoppers.
Just struggling. And you guys are right. Those front guys for the EC Glass defense, those are some big boys up there.
Loss of 8 officially. It'll be second down and 18 for the Lancers. And I've mentioned it before, I'll mention it again. It's an offense that can't afford to be behind the sticks. Two receivers here to the near side. Frank Ross takes the snap. He wants to throw. Here's the short out to Chaz Jackson. He just threw it too hard and too high and incomplete. Wasn't a bad idea.
Frank Ross seems a little upset with himself trying to get his first completion of the year here.
That'd have been sweet. And didn't look like it was going to go for very far.
Correct.
But would have been his first completion. Now Chloe's hitting things over here. I think she's getting frustrated too.
I'm trying to keep things down.
Okay, all right. You stick with that story.
Y'all are so mean.
Third and 18 for the Lancers. Here's Ross rolling to his right, just going to sling it down the field, and it is caught! It is caught by Chaz Jackson as he goes out of bounds at the 21-yard line. In double coverage, Chaz Jackson comes up with the catch.
Wow.
How about that? And I think there was there a flag that came in, too? It's not. Nope. It'll be a Lancer first down, and there's the first completion for Frank Ross. It was a doozy, too.
In spectacular fashion. Wow.
How long was that exactly?
40-yard pass play.
That is sensational. It was just a great catch.
Hey, yes, it was.
Jackson just decided he wasn't going to be denied. First and 10 for the Lancers at the Hilltopper 22-yard line. Johnson puts Jackson in motion. They hand it off to Jackson and a whistle. And what happened here? I think a timeout. Yep. Timeout called by Amherst with 2:22 to play in this ball game. It is EC Glass 42, Amherst 13. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 250 WBRG, WAMDRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network. How did Ross even throw that pass in this wind right now? Here's Frank. Going to keep it, trying to go to the left side. Breaks out a one tackle in the backfield. Gets ahead and skips over another. Gets inside the 20. Let's see where they end up spotting this thing.
That has been a very famous catchphrase for you tonight.
What's that?
Let's see where they spot this thing.
Yeah, you got to figure that they're not going to get it right. They're just not going to get it right. I told you, you cannot trust anyone in a strike shirt. Gain of 4 on the play, by the way. So I try to keep my composure. I don't know about everybody else up in this booth, but I'm sticking with my professionalism here.
There you go.
Second down and four. Here's Ross. Going to keep it going right, boy. He's just hit hard and dropped. There's Pretz again. A loss of two on the play.
It looked like an Amherst offensive lineman just stood up.
Yep.
And let Pretz go right past him.
So it's third and eight at the Hilltopper 20. Four down territory with almost a minute to play. Ross just letting the clock run. Now looks at the play clock with 6 seconds left on it. We'll take the snap. Hands off Xavier Ellis going to the right side. If he could get a couple of blocks, he'll get down close to the 15-yard line. It's going to be about 3 yards shy of the first down. 40 seconds left to go. It's fourth down and three. You got to run the play here. Yeah. Yeah. Play clock hasn't started. And it's 25 seconds now, less than 25 seconds. The Lancers don't have to run the play if they don't want to.
If nothing else, let Blaine Johnson come on and kick a field goal here.
Fourth down and three. 14 seconds to play in the game. Ross will take it. Roll to his left. Going to let the little flare pass out to Brogdon is incomplete. And 5 seconds left to go on the Hilltoppers. Will get a chance to line up in the victory formation. I love this win, though, don't you?
It's a twister coming.
Start to wonder. Looks like the Lancers are just going to line up on the sideline, or start to line up on the sideline. Defense will take the field for one last time. Kendrick lined up at the 10-yard line to take the snap. Lancers defense almost looks like they're nervous. They are going to try something here. Takes the snap, runs to his right. That's not Kendrick. He'll be brought down, and that's your ball game. The final score here from Lancer Stadium tonight: EC Glass Hilltoppers 42 and the Amherst County Lancers 13. We'll be back with the Lancers postgame show after we step aside for this timeout. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG, WAMVRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network. Back to Lancers Stadium and the Lancers postgame show as Amherst County falls here tonight to the EC Glass Hilltoppers by a score of 42-13. The Lancers finish up the season at 1-9 overall, 1-6 in Seminole District play. The EC Glass Hilltoppers are now 9-1, 6-1 going into the playoffs starting next Friday night. We'll come back and talk some more about it and here on the Lancers postgame show, so stick around. You're listening to Lancers Football on 105.1 FM and Super Talk 1050 WBRG, WAMVRadio.com, and on YouTube Live on the Lancers Sports Network.